Hello friends, in today's video of chapter ratio and proportion, we are going to cover question number 5 of exercise 7A. Right, so we'll be solving the next question. You can find the complete series of questions in description. I have mentioned the link also. Also friends, I am seeing people are watching my videos but they forget to subscribe my channel. So I am requesting you to please subscribe my channel. This actually gives me a lot of motivation to create more and more videos for you guys. I am just asking for your subscription friends. Please do subscribe and like and comment. If you find any difficulty, I will make a separate video for you guys. So please do subscribe. I am requesting again and again. Now let's go to the question number 5. So question is saying find the number which bears the same ratio to 7 by 33 that 8 by 22 does to 4 by 9, right? So here, first of all, we need to understand the question first. Question understanding is very important. So basically, here is asking to find the ratio of 7 is to 33 in such a way that it will come the same ratio when we solve 8 by 21 and 4 by 9. All right. So we need to find a ratio. If we solve with 7 by 33, then the answer should come same as if we solve 8 by 21 and 4 by 9. So let's try to understand or try to solve 8 by 21 and 4 by 9. Friends, what I'm going to explain you just now is not going to be written in your exam. This is something which is just for your understanding purpose, right? So let's try to solve this 8 by 21 and 4 by 9. So we can see 8 by 21 / 4 by 9, and if we solve this further, we'll be getting 8 by 21 into 9 by 4, and further we'll be getting 6 by 7, right? So if we solve 8 by 21 and 4 by 9, we'll be getting the answer 6 by 7. That means we are expecting a ratio with 7 by 33. If we solve that ratio, then answer will be 6 by 7 in that case also, right? So here, whatever, let me just put the pointer just a second. Yeah, so here this answer 6 by 7 should be the same if we solve 7 by 33 with that number which we need to find it out, right? So this both number will be same. So this is what question is saying. Now let's try to solve it. So for solving, I am just considering there will be a value x which is the number which required to solve further, right? So first value I have written 8 by 21 is to 4 by 9 is to x is to 7 by 33, right? So this is the just what I have written is mentioned in the question. Now we know that if a is to b is equal to c is to d, then if we solve this, we can write a by b is equal to c by d, and that will become ad is equal to bc, right? If we cross multiply, we can get ad is equal to bc. Now consider 8 by 21 as an a, 4 by 9 as a b, x is equal to c, and 7 by 33 as a d. And in that fashion, if we try to put this value, we will be getting a as an 8 by 21 into d. D is what? 7 by 33, right? And then what we required? B. B is what? 4 by 9. And C is what? X. And C is x. So we will be getting 8 by 21 into 7 by 33 is equal to 4 by 9 into x, right? Now if we solve this further, we will be getting the value of x as 2 by 11. So now the value, if we solve this with 7 by 33, we will be getting the same value what we have if we solve 8 by 21 is to 4 by 9, right? So friends, you will be getting your answer as x is equal to 2 by 11. Now what I said in my previous slide, I just need to double confirm that. So now just for your understanding purpose, this should not include in your answer what I am going to explain you right now. So we have answered 2 by 11 and 7 by 33 is our what we require to be calculate and that will make sure that the answer should come when we solve 8 by 21 to 4 by 9. So if we solve this further, we can see the answer is 6 by 7. And this is the same as we have mentioned in our previous slide, which is A. So that means we find the value of 6 by 7, which is the same as if we solve 8 by 21 to 4 by 9, right? So that's what is mentioned in this question. And the only trick here is you need to understand this concept where it's mentioned A is to B is equal to C is to D, and that will become AD is equal to BC. So if in case you will be having a 4 equation and you need to find one equation which is missing, then you can apply this kind of a question. Hope you like this video. Let me know if you find any difficulty, and do like, subscribe and comment, and do subscribe, friends. I am seeing people are not subscribing. I don't know why. Please do subscribe, friends. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching. Bye bye and take care.